2017, an innocent man accused of a crime has a choice. Hard time or prime time?
Sensational. Perfect contestant. I want him.
He must pay or play the running man.
On your mark.
I'll be back.
Go!
The highest rated TV show in history.
Guess they want us to stay.
It's a game between life and death.
Can you lift?
Tyreek Hill is the running man.
Is his life.
How about the life?
The Running Man.
From Arrowhead Stadium, preseason game number one, your Kansas City Chiefs 38, the Cincinnati Bengals 17. Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 season has begun, and we don't want to get too high, and we don't want to get too low about preseason game number one. Because there really isn't anything. The first preseason game and the fourth preseason game are kind of that. But we're excited. We're thrilled to have football back in Kansas City. Not only Kansas City, the entire league. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Kansas City Chiefs freaks worldwide of all ages. Thank you once again for joining me, Shaggy Shane, back for your 2019 season. Let's get to tonight's game. The Chiefs were on defense when they got the ball. The third play of the game, the Bengals make a play. But the ball stripped. Daniel Sorensen gets the fumble. He tries to run around. He gets hit. He fumbles the football. Tyrann Mathieu, the Honey Badger, he's runs around for 15 yards, makes some plays, gets down. The Chiefs think they have the ball, and they did. I'm not being biased. I'm not being a homer, but that was a catch. That was a fumble, but they went to the freaking review, and they said it was an incomplete pass. Well, Andy Reid acted like, well, that's enough. That's enough for my starters. I'm going to take Tyrann Mathieu and Breshad Breeland off the field. Frank Clark didn't start. If it was a regular season game, Frank Clark would have started tonight's game. So he pretty much pulled up what starters he had after that incomplete pass was overturned from that fumble. And the Bengals went on a long drive, 8-minute drive, continued that drive for a touchdown. So we can't really evaluate the Chiefs' new 4-3 defensive scheme because of the situation where, you know, Andy Reid pulled the Honey Badger after his fumble, what he thought was fumble recovery. And We saw a lot of Juan Thornhill get some action. We saw Tano Pasnio get a big sack before first half. You know, I just want to evaluate the defense here real quickly from what we saw in the first half with the guys that are going to be in the mix to making this football team. Like I said, Tano Pasnio had a big sack. Breeland Speaks had a sack. It was nice to see the defense play, but, you know, you felt like you wanted more. But like I said, the first preseason game and the fourth preseason game, you're not going to see what you, you're not going to see what the defense is going to end up being. But getting to the point of the Chiefs defense, it's going to take the Chiefs defense week four or week five of the regular season to gain an identity. You can't change your entire defensive scheme with a new defensive coaching staff, a better coaching staff, a lot better coaching staff on paper. You Chiefs fans know about the Chiefs coaching staff. Spagnuolo, the guy that Daly they got from New England, House they got from Kentucky. This Chiefs defensive coaching staff is great. Definitely compared to what they had last year. So the Chiefs offense, in my opinion, and we're going to address this as weeks go on, but looking right now, it's going to be till week four, till week five. I feel, in my opinion, that the defense gels into its own. But let's talk about the Chiefs offense. Patrick Mahomes came out clicking. First and 10 at their own 16-yard line. He hits Kelce on a beautiful touch pass. 36 yards later, Kelce's making moves. He's down the field. Great play by Travis Kelce. Then later on in the drive, Patrick Mahomes hits Blake Bell. The Chiefs are trying to get a second tight end, and Blake Bell makes the play, gets down the field. Let's look at these stats. Let's look at these stats for your Kansas City Chiefs, especially from Patrick Mahomes. Patrick Mahomes was 4-4 for 66 yards. The leading receiver with the start, well, the leading receiver is going to be Mecole Hardman. I mean, straight up, Mecole Hardman had two receiving yards, 31 yards. Granted, his touchdown pass of 17 yards was a quick shovel pass. Mecole Hardman's going to be a great addition to this Kansas City Chiefs offense. Phenomenal. Put in with Tyreek Hill, the cheetah, Sammy Watkins, and Travis Kelce. Man, he's going to be a beast, and he showed it tonight. I really liked Mecole Hardman. And how about Darwin Thompson? Let's look at that kid. Darwin Thompson, he had five rushes for 22 yards. He had that monster 18-yard run where he hurdled the defender, took him down to the four. There was a holding penalty, brought him back to the 29. Chase Linton dumped it off to Darwin Thompson, and he's chucking in, wearing that number 25. Looking like Jamaal Charles, angling to the corner of the end zone for a beautiful touchdown. Darwin Thompson and Mecole Hardman are going to be special. They're going to be special moving forward. Again, there's a lot to be. I want to see more from the Chiefs defense. We need to get these defensive players to get some reps. Again, I like the sack by Breland Speaks and Tano Passanio. But I need to see more. You know, Juan Thornhill, the second-round draft pick, he's looking good in camp. I want to see some more out of him. And I believe once Frank Clark gets some reps in the preseason game, he's going to be great as well. I know I've said this on previous shows, and it's something that you may think I just say to say, but it is an exciting time to be a Kansas City Chiefs fan. This defense is going to be really, really good. It's going to be really, really good. In a 4-3 scheme, what concerns me is Dorian O'Daniel really slipped. Ben Neiman got a lot more playing time over Dorian O'Daniel, and I honestly thought going into training camp that Dorian O'Daniel would push Raglan out of the linebacker position in a 4-3, but Ben Neiman's getting more reps. It may be just unfortunate for Dorian O'Daniel, but Reggie Raglan's playing solid. The linebackers are playing solid right now in camp. Again, next week in Pittsburgh, we're going to want to see, in a 4-3 scheme, we're going to want to see Frank Clark. We're going to want to see him get reps playing alongside of Chris Jones. The Honey Badger, the second and third week are basically the better preseason games to see going into the season. I want to see Honey Badger play more than three plays. I want to see Frank Clark, like I've been mentioning. I want to see Chris Jones. I want to see these guys gain continuity. Andy Reid's more apt to say, Andy Reid's more apt to let Patrick Mahomes go out there and play and take chances with Patrick Mahomes playing than Honey Badger. I don't know if he's protecting the Honey Badger. I don't know if Andy Reid's just taking a baby steps to let him play, but we need to see him play going forward. But next week in Denver, or in Denver, in Pittsburgh, I'm sure we're going to see Frank Clark. I'm sure we're going to see more of these players play. And it should be the second, third preseason games are going to be great. The Chiefs this week signed Maurice Claiborne, former Dallas Cowboy and New York Jet. He's got a four-game suspension for PEDs, so we've got to sit by that. We don't know who's going to be the – I don't know who's that going to bump out, because we've got Charvarius Ward at corner. We've got Rashard Breeland and Kendall Fuller. Is Maurice Claiborne just going to be somebody to add depth in nickel in situations? Is Maurice Claiborne week five? This is something, again, we can address in October when Maurice Claiborne gets on the field. Where is Maurice Claiborne going to play? When is he going to play in preseason? He hasn't played yet, and he hasn't practiced yet, so that's going to be definitely something that we're going to watch going forward. As you've seen on the preview coming in, Cheetah, the running man from Red Tribe Cinema. I've made videos with Clay Wendler, Red Tribe Cinema before, and all have been fun and important, but the magnitude of Cheetah, the running man, it tells the story of everything that Tyreek Hill has gone through this offseason. You know it, I know it. The local media really slammed Tyreek Hill, and it's a shame. Shame on the Kansas City Star. Shame on KCTV5. As a lifelong Kansas Citian, when I turn on local news, I want to see non-biased entire story. And local news, KCTV5 really dropped the ball. Wendell Anschutz rolled over in his freaking grave because KCTV5 dropped the ball. Shame on them. This is the last season, preseason, that the KCTV5 will host the Chiefs, because the Chiefs are done with KCTV5. Again, Red Tribe Cinema, August 25th, Cheetah, the running man, will tell the entire story of Tyreek Hill's offseason. The truth, nothing but the truth. But we are back. We are back. Football is back in Kansas City. It's an exciting time to be a Kansas City Chiefs fan. You guys all kick ass. One more drink from my homies. Let's hope going into next week, let's get Frank Clark out on the field. Let's get the Honey Badger to play more than three snaps. Tano passing, yo. You were bringing it. Freeland Speaks, keep getting after it. Juan Thornhill, keep making plays. Darwin Thompson, McCole Hardman, you showed why you're special. Chiefs fans, you showed why you're special. I'd like to see Jamal Custis play more with the starting unit. But in this offense, you're not going to see big 6'5", 218-pound wide receivers. You're going to see wide receivers all between 5'10 and maybe 6 foot. In the shifty offense, Randy Reed can mix and match them, run them out of the backfield, make plays. But moving forward, props to your Kansas City Chiefs. Way to go, Kyle Shermer. Arrowhead Stadium is only a short drive. 4 miles, baby. Home opener. Shaggy Shane will be there. Again, you guys all kick ass. I will see you next Saturday night when the Chiefs invade Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. They're going to be waving the orange, the terrible towel. Tomahawk. I love you guys. See you next Saturday evening. Until then, this is Shaggy Shane saying, go Chiefs!